On this car you're going to find four fuse boxes. One is going to be right there on the driver's side, one on the passenger side, another one right next to the steering wheel under that panel, and the last one under the back seat on the passenger side. So let's start with the biggest one, which is on the driver's side. Let's remove this cap. Now with a screwdriver in cross, you've got six bolts around this cover, so you can get access to these relays under here. Right, so let's zoom in a little bit. Let's start with fuse number two, which is display control unit and cigarette lighter. Fuse number three is for the combination switch, low beam switch, washer switch, wiper switch, and glove compartment lamp. Number four is for instrument cluster, automatic heater, coolant circulation pump, for some models also the air condition, and a part of the ACP. Number five and six are missing. This means that this car doesn't have some options. Number seven is for instrument cluster, automatic heater, ventilator blower, air conditioning control unit, and acceleration pedal control sensor. Number eight is missing, but that will be also for the air conditioning push button control unit. Number nine is for the electric steering lock control unit. Now let's move further to fuse number 10. This is going to be for the rear end wiper motor relay and the washer pump switchover relay. Also for the airbag indicator and warning lamp. Fuse number 11 is for the radio, navigation processor, driver seat adjustment relay, and front passenger seat adjustment relay. Now keep in mind that all these fuses on this side are just reserves. You've got each fuse with the number on the side. So we are on the fuse number 12. This is for the front heated seat and rear heated seat, rear end door wiper motor relay, and switch for electric roller blind for the rear window. Fuse number 13 is this 10 amps one for airbag indicator and warning lamp again, driver seat side airbag sensor, front passenger side airbag sensor, radio and navigation processor, restraint system control unit, and seat belt emergency tensioning retractor. If you have parking sensor, number 14 is for that. Number 17, if you have it, it's for the stationary heater timer, steering angle sensor, and data link connector pin 3. And number 18 is the rear driver's side door control unit. Number 19, this big 40 amps fuse, is for the high pressure and return pump, ACP and bus control unit. It can also be for the transmission oil fan unit and additional fan unit for the coolant or transmission oil. And number 20, this 70 amps fuse is for the air condition control unit, all the functions of it. Now on other newer car, instead of this hole, you're going to find other fuses which are going to be responsible for the comfort of the drivers. So this car doesn't have such things. Let's jump to fuse number 39, which is for the oil cooler fan. Number 40 is for the horn. 41, control unit. 42, windshield washer heater. 43, windscreen washers, and 44 for windshield wiper. Basically, this is for the pump of the washer fluid, and this one is for the wiper itself. All right, so moving further to the relays, we've got a couple of relays here. This one is for the horn, this one is for the glow plugs and injectors. These two yellow ones are for the windshield wiper motor. This one is the switch, and this one is for the speed. And down here we've got the ABS pump, the one responsible with the brakes. And finally, this relay, I don't know for what it is, because I believe it's attached after the car was made. But if you guys know about it, just leave it in the comments below for everybody else to know. Down here we've got a diagnostic port. You need an adapter to connect a regular OBD2 port scanner. And with that being said, let's go ahead and have a look on the other box. So we've got four screws. Let's remove these. And you probably noticed that on the previous fuse box, we didn't have a lot of fuses for the computer of the car. Therefore, you're going to find them here. This is the K40 relay box. This one is the traction control. And then we've got the computer on top here. So if, for example, your car doesn't start, obviously you've got the starter relay here, but also the other small electronics for the engine to run. So if, for example, your car will not start, which is the most common problem and probably the reason why you're watching this, well, it's a good idea to start with this K40 relay unit, which will include the starter relay together with the fuses for different electronics into the computer. The computer will need information from the engine to know exactly when to spray the injectors. So therefore, if for example one of these fuses, which is responsible with reading the pressure in the fuel rail, is blown, then the computer will not command to the injectors to spray the fuel, therefore the engine will not start. Now let's have a look inside the cabin, where you can remove this cover and you're gonna find another small fuse box. So we've got like that. Fuse number one slot is empty. Fuse number two is for the brake pedal position. Fuse number three is for the headlamp high beam. Fuse number four is for the indicators and interior rear view mirror, parking aid and rear screen wiper. Fuse number four is for the indicators and interior rear view mirror. Fuse number five is for the headlamp high beam. Fuse number six is for the headlamp low beam. Fuse number seven is for the tail lamps. Fuse number 8 is for the headlamp low beam. Fuse number 9 is for the front fog lamps. Fuse number 10 is for the side and tail lamps. Fuse number 11 is for the headlamp adjustment and license plate lamps. And fuse number 12 is for the rear fog lamps. Basically, all these fuses are for some illumination. Finally, let's have a look under the back seat. This car is quite dirty, but we are interested in the fuses. The fuse box is right here. Okay, so let's start with the relays. If you have another relay right on this side where is the hole, this is gonna be for the fuel pump relay, the one which is in the fuel tank. Then we've got the seat adjustment relay for the driver side and seat adjustment relay for the passenger side. Now we've got fuse number one, which is for the door function control module, electric window, heated door mirror and seat adjustment. Fuse number two, door function control module. Fuse number three is for the interior lamp rear and center console switch assembly, tailgate lamp and minibar, if you have such thing. Fuse number four, multifunction control module, alarm system signal, interior rear view mirror and rain sensor, sunroof and vanity mirror lamp. Fuse number five is for the audio unit alarm system horn, CD changer, central locking and navigation system. This car doesn't have fuse number six because it's for the fuel pump. Fuse number seven, tailgate closing aid. Fuse number eight, seat control module. Number 10, refrigerator box. Number 11, alarm system and steering position sensor, ACP. 13 is for the seat control module. Seat control module again. These two were for the front and these two for the rear. And finally, the fuse number 19 is for the heated rear window and number 20 is just missing. Okay guys, so those were the locations of all the fuses and relays from this car. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Also, if you are new to this channel and you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Check out the other videos I made about this car or other cars. And don't forget to subscribe. It's free for you and it's gonna motivate me to make a lot more videos for you guys in the future. So stay tuned and I will see you soon.